The aim of this next section is to help you understand how important menu design can be in the F&B industry, and how some of the most successful food brands have engineered the menu to maximize profit and meet customer expectations. Off the top of your head, what comes to mind when you hear menu design? Many of you probably first thought of the physical design and look of the menu, the font size, how different sections are presented, even the material used. But menu design is a lot more complex. It is about an offering that matches and builds on a brand's personality. Take Antonio's, a family-run Italian restaurant. It positions itself as a traditional Italian restaurant, and its menu is therefore very simple in design, but also in the dishes featured in the menu. This fits the brand image. A poke chain could be considered more trendy and up to date. In recent years, poke has become one of the biggest fast casual dining trends. Its menu is testament to that, featuring things like kombucha, kale, quinoa, hummus, and more. Menu design is therefore dependent on your target customer and market demographics. There is, of course, the actual food and variety on offer, as well as a profitability aspect of each menu item. Please note, variety does not always mean quantity. Let's take a look. We're going to flip through this example from a table service restaurant serving a wide range of dishes. Can you count the number of sections? Across these pages, the brand offers over 65 dishes, not even counting its desserts, categorized into 12 different sections. Whilst initially this may appear as a good way of pleasing as many customers as possible and adapting to different tastes, the menu quickly becomes overwhelming. It would take you a good 5 minutes to read through it. Even when you've picked your fish bowl, you then need to choose how it's served. With rice, potatoes, or carbless. Generally, center guests are looking for a place to eat that is convenient and that should not take too much of their time. This means that even sit-down establishments and restaurants should be wary of making customers wait or even having menus that take them almost as long to read as to eat. This is another example of a menu that is perhaps more successful. Firstly, it is completely on brand with the same colors used in the menu as in the Dutch flag and in the Dutch Originals logo. The imagery is playful and suggests a laid-back, relaxed atmosphere, a space that's also appropriate for families. Focusing on the menu offer itself, all food has been kept to one page and dishes are clearly categorized. If I'm after a salad, my eye is immediately drawn to that section and I know what to order. Finally, there are clear indications of vegan and vegetarian dishes marked with symbols. When looking to onboard a fashion brand, we look at the brand's full product offer and visual identity. For F&B, a menu is a brand's DNA and primary point of communication with the customer. Bigger is not always better, particularly when it comes to menus. Walk into an ice cream shop and there are so many options. You could choose cookies and cream, triple chocolate, or lemon cheesecake. Perhaps pistachio or caramel would be better. Or maybe plain vanilla. The experience detailed above is the paradox of choice, and we all experience it. With so many options, it does not matter what you select. You'll probably think you made the wrong choice. Aside from overwhelming the guest, big menus inevitably lead to the need for convenience foods for practical reasons. Is this the image all food outlets want to portray? Big menus also create a need for more refrigeration, larger freezers, expansive dry goods storage, more diverse equipment, and a significant investment of time for purchasing and inventory control. Big menus always lead to shortages, and items that the service staff must explain to the guests are no longer available. big menus always lead to more waste and spoilage, impacting profitability. Let's take a closer look. When considering menu design, there are three key factors that drive profitability: portion control, food cost, and pricing. Now, plate waste refers to any food the diner does not finish and that is left on their plate when it is cleared. Maybe that lasagna tasted terrible and the diner could not stomach another bite, but maybe the slice was just way too big for a single person. This is an issue with portion control. Consistent over-portioning can seriously affect profit margins. Here are a few points to consider. First off, a starter is designed to begin the meal and not dominate it. Its size should therefore be smaller than mains, except when considering starters to share, like croquetas or chicken wings. Generally, starters are also priced lower. Operators should also consider reviewing portion sizes if they notice that over a period of time, customers are consistently unable to finish their meal. When preparing recipes, the kitchen should also use the same size ladles and serving spoons, and even a commercial kitchen scale to ensure that each plate leaving the pass is the same in size. By controlling portion sizes, operators will not only keep their food costs in line, but they will ensure customers receive consistency when they order their meals. There are a number of things that impact the cost of ingredients, as well as how operators choose to price their menu items. Food costs are impacted by ingredient seasonality and availability, as well as storage conditions, shelf life, and a good or bad supplier management. Something as silly as buying berries in the middle of winter can cause the production cost of a dessert to skyrocket. Pricing a menu might not be so straightforward as putting a markup. One needs to consider the profit margins, how competitors are priced, and the customer's perception and profile. A luxury 5-star hotel might be able to charge 40 euros for a basic club sandwich because its clientele is prepared to pay that much. But if a small sandwich shop started charging that much for a cheese toasty, our guests would not be happy. This brings us onto the concept of menu engineering. What do you think is McDonald's most profitable item? In absolute terms, McDonald's fountain drinks have the highest profit margin. They are priced at the equivalent of $1 per standard serving and cost a mere 50 cents to produce, resulting in an 85% profit margin. The problem with this question is that it does not factor in popularity. Having profit margin of a menu item is insignificant if we don't know how many we sell. This is where menu engineering comes into play, a simple tool to identify which items are most profitable and popular. The menu engineering matrix takes both aspects into consideration. On this graph, you can see profitability plotted against popularity. Popularity represents the number of items sold in a given period. There are four distinct categories: stars, dogs, puzzles, and plow horses. What can you do with this information? Stars: money-making and popular. These items are winners. Keep them. Dogs: these are neither profitable nor popular. Operators should therefore question whether these should even feature on the menu at all. Puzzles: these items have potential as they are very profitable, but for some reason they just are not selling. Operators could consider highlighting or repositioning these items on the menu, or incorporating them into a promotion to increase sales volume. Plow horse: the operator knows how to sell these items, but perhaps a price increase, ingredient change, portion variation could boost productivity. Be careful though, a price increase isn't always the solution. Maybe the reason why this dish is so popular is precisely because it is the most affordable among expensive dishes. A very basic Excel sheet can help build a menu matrix in seconds. Here we have an example we have created for the Ivy, an all-day restaurant, looking at just a few of its menu items. Most of them have already been categorized based on whether or not their profit margin is higher or lower than the average profit margin for the menu. Same goes for the units sold. We have hidden the profit margin and quantity sold for three items. Let's take a look at the chicken skewers. Priced at $15.95 and costing just €1.60 to produce, this dish has a profit margin of 90%. Good news, right? Well, actually, the Ivy only sells about 70 per period, which is lower than the average for the menu. It is therefore considered a puzzle. What can be done about this? Well, the Ivy could consider renaming the dish. Chicken thigh skewer is not exactly enticing. Lemon and herb chicken souvlaki might sound more intriguing and would stand out on the menu. Next, let's take a look at the Mediterranean platter. Based on its menu price and cost to produce, it's considered a plow horse, which means it is popular among diners, but not that profitable. A possible solution could be to make an ingredient swap to lower the cost of production. The platter currently includes some dips, grilled vegetables, and beetroot balls. Beetroot is not always seasonal, and suppose they were very expensive during the winter. A possible alternative could be to replace the balls with some marinated feta. Lastly, we have the mushroom tagliatelle, which the Ivy sells for €15.50. With limited need for ingredients and being popular amongst guests, this is a star. Definitely keep this on the menu. Menu design is a very complex part of a restaurant offering. It includes everything from the creative layout to the theme. All of this will be dependent on your target audience and market trends. Remember, a smaller and authentic menu can actually be a saving grace. It's less confusing for the customer and can be easier to manage back of house. As we saw, profitability is mainly impacted by portion control, food costs, and menu pricing. A simple menu matrix can be created using Excel and is a vital tool that should be reviewed biannually to effectively manage operations. We hope that following this presentation, you will begin to spot a strong menu when eating out and understand why you appreciate a restaurant, from its pricing to portion control or even presentation.